Listen to these words of Charlie Chaplin. Life is a tragedy when seen in close-up, but a comedy in the long shot. Most of us are living a life of tragedy. We are too concerned about anything and everything. We live as if we are the center of universe. Look at the kind of thoughts that you have throughout the day. All day you're just thinking about yourself. You have to get somewhere important. You have to meet important people. You have to do things that are really important. You're concerned about your reputation. You're concerned about how you look, how you talk. You're just making your life too serious. And this starts reflecting in other aspects of your life as well. The trivial starts bothering you. Your phone falls down and there is a scratch on the screen. You get too serious about it. You take it as a personal loss. You're going on the road. Another car bumps into your car, there is a small dent, and you become too furious about that thing. You start fighting for this. This is not something that I am making up, it's happening in our society. At mass level, as a society, we have become a very nervous society, an anxious society, a society which is too uptight. So this thing has to be dropped. Since childhood, we are obsessed about seriousness. Everyone just says that you be serious about your studies, be serious about your work, and not just this. Even lovers, initially when people start dating, this is the most common thing that you hear. Are you serious about me? So this obsession with seriousness has to be dropped. We have to live a life which is full of joy, not full of seriousness. So how should we drop this seriousness? I will talk about two practical strategies. The first is to take a long shot and the second is to miss out on the important stuff. Let's get into the first strategy. Chaplin says that when you look at the long shot in life, it becomes a comedy. So I want you to zoom out a little bit in your life. Right now you think you are really important, zoom out a little bit and you see that there are more than 7 billion people like you who think that they are too important. Zoom out a little further and you see that more than 7 billion important people, this self-importance that they have cultivated, are living on a small ball of mud, which is just hanging around in this vast emptiness. Zoom out a little further, trillions of stars, billions of galaxies, this eternal dance of existence that goes on and on. When you perceive this thing, you realize that you're just a tiny part of this eternal dance. You become more humble in your life and you drop this seriousness that you have cultivated in your life. You know, I am reminded of this movie, Cynic Dicky New York, in which there is a quote. When the movie ends, this is the realization that the director wants to convey, that in the long run, nothing matters in life. These are the lines. You realize you are not special. You have struggled into existence and are now slipping silently out of it. This is everyone's experience, every single one. So make it a point that you do not live your life like this. Don't struggle in life. When death comes, have this much experience in you, have this much wisdom in you to say in those moments that you have lived a life full of joy. You have celebrated your existence and now you're slowly slipping out of it. So we can learn really something significant from these lines of Charlie Kaufman. Always take life in a non-serious way. Another way to look at the long shot is to go back into the past. Remember the times when you thought there was a thing which was too important. For example, going back into your childhood, you can remember times when you thought getting a toy was the most important thing. Growing up in school, you thought getting into the school team, scoring good marks, or being flattered by teachers was the most important things. Today you can laugh about those things. So this is what Charlie Chaplin wants to say. When we take a long shot, everything becomes a comedy. The things that are bothering you right now, the things that seem really important to you right now, won't be important things when you will look back at them from the future vantage point. They are important right now. And I'm not saying that everything is unimportant. There must be things that are really important in your life. But your evaluation of the important things is wrong. 99% of the things in your life are unimportant. You are concerned about the opinion of other people. You are concerned about how you dress, how you talk, how you walk, what people are thinking about you. These are not the things that you have to be concerned about. These are the trivial stuff that you can take in a non-serious way. So always make it a point that whenever the bout of seriousness grips you, possesses you, you use this strategy of taking a long shot. Second strategy that I want to talk about is miss out on the important stuff. Right now you think that you're too important. Someone invites you to a social event, you think that without your presence, that event won't happen. Just say no to that event or don't go to that event. You will come to realize how unimportant you are. The event will go on happening, your life will go on happening. Yes, people will gossip about you, but people in any case will gossip about you. Whether you get there or not is totally irrelevant. Human beings have this tendency to gossip about things. So you're wasting a lot of time in your life, lot of energy in your life, in the trivial stuff. Doing this thing, practicing this thing, you will realize that you are not very important. You will become more relaxed in your life. So I want you to practice these two techniques, to miss out on the important stuff and to always take a long shot in the moments when you become too serious. Doing this, you will become more relaxed in your life, and relaxation always results in joy. The byproduct of relaxation is joy. You cannot be joyful in your life being serious, being tense, being too uptight. Joy is only a possibility when mentally, physically, you are relaxed. So just practice these two techniques. Lastly, I'm reminded of this analogy that Alan Watts, the philosopher, used very often. He used to compare dolphins with humans. In those times, it must have been a thing in scientific magazines or journals that perhaps dolphins are as intelligent as human beings. He took it a step further. He said, perhaps dolphins are much more intelligent than human beings. They are more evolved. They are not taking life very seriously. They are not doing any important things. They are not building a democracy underneath the ocean. They are not creating big empires, great empires. They are simply living in harmony with the nature, and they are so playful. They are just enjoying life throughout the day. Today we can discard it as a bogus analogy, but that's not the point. The facticity of the intelligence of dolphin is not a point. The point is that Alan Watts had a vision that a playfulness is much higher value than seriousness. In a better world, in a mature society, playfulness will be appreciated and seriousness will be condemned. Right now, the opposite is happening. So let's not wait for the better world or a mature society to happen. Let's become ourselves mature. Let's become ourselves better. Let's always choose playfulness over seriousness. I hope that you will apply this thing in your life, and I wish you all the best for that.